Hi, Attorney Star Glocktka. This is Ari, and I am reporting from my Wednesday duty on Tranny Star Glocktka, TSG. Tranny Star, I'm really not afraid to use the word tranny as a trans person, and I am afraid of others who use it, but I like the choice of language in our username for many reasons, but I understand why many trans people don't like it, and why it's controversial and scary to see, and unfortunate a part of our username. But let's get to this topic, shall we? Let's get to this awesome topic by Morgan, whose topic is presented like this. How are legal gender markers changed where you live? How does it affect you? What would you change about the system if you could? Okay, what I would change? Gender markers changed by my request instantly without question. That's what I would like to change. I would like this to be an easier process, a more fluid process. Though right now it actually doesn't seem that difficult here where I'm at, and given my situation currently. I recently went to go get my license, not my gender marker changed, but updated since it expired, and I needed an Illinois license. And I asked about that, and apparently what I really need right now is just a physician's letter, and I can actually go to Southern Illinois University, to the LGBT Resource Center, and thankfully there's someone there that I believe can write me a letter, and I can start to get that stuff changed. But yeah, I actually need to do more research on. Otherwise, I know that I can easily go to Howard Brown, which is where I get my hormones. Not so easily, actually, because it's all the way in Chicago, and I know someone there will be able to write me a letter. If I could change the system, I would want more facilities like Howard Brown to be closer and more accessible, which is an informed consent way of accessing transition needs, and it's just a really awesome facility. I would just want more LGBT, labeled facilities to be more accessible for everyone, really, so they can have this sort of assistance. And I know a lot of people are really still struggling out there. You know, while we're playing the system's game, I think just having things more accessible and available, and for things to just be smoother for LGBT folks, trans folks, queer folks, I think would just be my ideal way of wanting to alter the system a bit, because things are not really that accessible. You need money. And trans people are kind of at the bottom of that of that accessibility, right? Just money access is not easy for trans people, especially when you consider jobs and the homeless rate of trans folks. What I'm reading right now, though, in this article that was last updated in 2012, is that civil rights advocates filed a court-supervised agreement Monday that will make it easier for transgender individuals in Illinois to get accurate birth certificates reflecting their gender. The agreement asks to end the requirement for genital surgery in order to change the gender marker, which I think is huge that that's at least being recognized at all in any systemic way, that genitals or sex and gender are different, right? So I think that is just really awesome. So basically that means that I just had accurate information that you just need a licensed physician's opinion on the matter, and I think that that's just a way that you can start the process of changing your birth certificate and, you know, all that information. Anyway, I hope that that was helpful to anyone maybe living in Illinois. I am happy to see that it is a lot smoother, and so far I've been having definitely thoughts on wanting to change this myself and feeling ready to change it. So I'll keep you guys updated on how this process works for me, because you know, it sounds easy when I say it, but we'll see actually how the process works when I start doing it, and the obstacles I face with folks who may not understand what's going on, and as I kind of deal with that. But otherwise, that's all I have to say right now. So yeah, goodbye, friendly friends.